you gorgeous human beings out there. My name is Autumn the Ripper, and today we are back with another episode of Skyrim. In the last episode, we had just gotten the Golden Claw back to old dude in Dragon's Reach in Whiterun. So now we are off to see the Greybeards up in High Hrothgar, and we get to climb the 7,000 steps! Woohoo! And, Hey!
There's been talk amongst the guards that you are Dragonborn.
Yeah, that's me.
Such a thing. Surely that's not possible.
Go away! But anyways, I'm super excited to continue playing this game, and, we'll see exactly what happens. I mean, I've played this game before, but, you know, things change. People change. Dragons don't change, but people can change.
What is it?
It's nothing. Go away! Oh, and I forgot to say in the last video, in my episode 1 of Limbo, I got a new mic! Yay! Clap, 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 clap. I know my last Skyrim video was kind of crap, just because I was using Twitch live stream, and then I would upload those to YouTube and then download them.
And I took an arrow in the knee.
Shut up! Good. I'm glad you took an arrow in the knee. Let me get away from this guy so I can continue telling you guys. Okay. We're gonna go stand by the fire. Pretty. So I got a new mic, which is super, super exciting. So the quality of my videos are gonna progressively get a little bit better and better as I kind of get, like, my groove of what exactly I'm doing. I mean, I know exactly what I want to do. I want to play video games and reach out to you guys and really just have a lot of fun with this. I mean, I've always been interested in, like, the YouTube community and the online-based community. I think it's an awesome thing. You know, when I was younger, I used to go online and chat with people all over the world, and I think that's so cool that the internet and the mobile webs has really allowed people to branch out and do stuff like that. But yeah, I also got the Elgato HD60, which has improved video quality tremendously. I mean, crystal clear, 1080p, 60 frames per second. It's just fantastic. If anyone plans on doing any kind of recording or even live streaming, I highly recommend the Elgato HD60 or the HD60S. They are fantastic devices, and I'm in love with it. Like, I think I want to marry it. Mwah. But anyway, let's get into Skyrim. I know this is going to take an absolute dick here to get everywhere that I need to go. So, without further ado, let's go! Move! Is that not the guy that's screaming at the tree? Thought it was.
Damn those gray manes to oblivion. They want to back the storm close.
Gray manes? No one wants to battle you. I just need to get to Hi Hrothgar.
Need a blade? You should talk to Adrian at the forge.
Adrian? Hey! My boss's name is Adrian.
We're looking for someone in Whiterun. We'll pay good money for information.
Who are you looking for?
A woman. A foreigner in these lands. Redguard, like us. She's likely not using her true name. We will pay for any information regarding her location. We are not welcome here in Whiterun. So we will be in Rorikstead if you learn anything.
Why are you looking for this person?
It's none of your concern. All you need to know is that we're paying for information. If that doesn't interest
payment
you,
is good.
Feel free to walk away. If you locate her, find us in Rorikstead.
Shh! I'll be the bigger man and walk away. Alright. Off to High Hrothgar. Whee! Taken the hobbits to Isengard, to Isengard, to Isengard! I hope every single person that watches my channel or subscribes to my channel is at least seen one of the Lord of the Rings movies. At least one of the Hobbits as well. They're so good! How can you not watch them? How? You know what? I take that back. My best friend has only watched the Hobbit movies as of what I've showed him. Which is sad. I love him. He's my BFF. BFF for life. Wait, doesn't BFF mean best friend? Oh, best friend forever. Duh. God. Sometimes my brain no work. Hamar shame discovered. It not me, I'm not here. What are you? Oh yeah, I do have my bow. Come, come.
Hello? Who's there?
Ah! Ooh, shoot him right in the butt. I got him in the arse. Woo! Come on, man. Don't need no spread eagle. I will gladly take all of your belongings, except for your fur shoes, your fur braces, your hide armor, your Nord meat, and your iron dagger. And your longbow. I have two of those. Why do I have two of those? Oh well. Who went down here? Wait a minute. Okay, I knew it. That's the way I'm supposed to go, and there's a bunch of goodies up here. Like arrows. Chest. More gold! Which is that valued at? Nah. I already have quite a bit of gold. Don't really need useless crap taking up my inventory. Whoa!
Is someone there?
Yeah. Go. Go away. You saw nothing. Fuck! Ooh, what's that? Oh, I already have one of those. I don't know. Ooh, yes. Yes, 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 yes. We're gonna put on vampire armor. Keep the novice hood. Boots do I have on? Imperial light boots? I mean, I guess that works. Oh god! Ah! What the fuck, man? Oh! Oh, that's a button. Does she have boots? She does have boots. I want these. Vampire boots. That's a what we want. Oh. Should I take out old girl over here and then this guy? Or that guy and then this girl, since he's closer. I really want to try for a headshot with her, though. Ready? Ready? Hey! Ah! Why you gotta move for? Come back. Really, if the arrow comes from this way, why would someone be over there? That's just one of them questions and ain't never gonna be answered. Oh fuck. Oh god. Oh!
Thought I heard something.
Before I took an arrow to the knee. Okay, this is not working. I am dressed for success, and we are ready to mingle. Not with that. I want to sleep in a coffin? Hello, yes, knock knock. I would like to sleep in one of your coffins, please. Ooh, scroll. More Elder Scroll. It wasn't me. You got me on the counter.
Ah! I thought I heard.
It wasn't me. And they got me on the sofa. It wasn't me. Hey, we'll take that.
Something's not right.
I can end this little game.
Oh no. Picture this, we're both butt naked on the bed. How could I forget that I had given her an extra key? The whole time she was standing there, she never took her eyes off. I didn't have to go to bitter potato kibble. I think it's pretty clear I don't actually know the words to that song. It's like when you walk into your best friend's house and the door was unlocked and you don't see anybody, you're like, hello. Oh god.
Someone there?
Are you stuck? Shoot you in the face! Odd. Meh. Fucking lame. Oh, right in the neck, man. That is... That's not good. Let me look at you. I said, oh god. I didn't want to ask to bend you off your skirt. My bad. My bad. Moving on. Where did the arrow come from? Hello. Right in the dick.
I'm going to the hole.
Motherfucker. Fuck! Go, 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 go. Oh, you're gonna die.
Now. My turn.
No, I don't think so.
No.
There's just a pile of bodies. Ooh. Oh, look, it's a cuddle puddle, guys. Aww. Oh, no. Ooh, meat. Again, I don't really like things cluttering up my inventory in this game because you run out of room really quick unless you actually, like, improve your stamina, which allows you to carry more items, or more weight, more so. But the more weight you have... Oh, fuck. Where do I... Eep. Heh. Cool. The more weight you carry, the more annoying it gets just because you... You end up, like, running into things that you would really, really like to take, like a sword or a shield or some cool armor. And should I go up or down? Should we go? I can't go up, so we're gonna go down. But you find all these really, really cool things that you can't carry because you have too much fucking bread. Or horse meat. Hey, buddy. You wanna be friends? Oh, you can hear him, like... He sounds like a dog with asthma. Oh, excuse me? So, my dog has asthma. I mean, it's not really asthma. She's a boxer, so she just kind of snorts. Oh, fuck me. Really? Go away! It scared the ever-loving fuck out of me. Ah! No! No, I'm not ready for a bear! Bone break fever? What the fuck is bone break fever? No. No. Please go away. Go. Take a little nap. Oh, man. I got some kind of disease. Fuck. Oh my god. Wow. Oh, so help me god. Is this the way that I just came from? It is, isn't it? Fuck! Ah! God, why am I so jumpy today?
Steps again, Klimek?
Not today. I'm just not ready to make the climb to High Hrothgar. The path
I am.
Isn't safe.
Me.
Aren't the
pick
Greybeards
me.
Beards expecting some supplies?
Yep.
Honestly,
me.
I'm not certain. Passing
Shut
through
up.
On your
Talk
way to
me.
High Hrothgar. About to make a delivery up there myself.
Anything you can tell me about High Hrothgar?
I've been
High
to the monastery many times, but I've never even laid eyes on one of the Greybeards. Not that I'd care to. Being masters of the Thuum. They could kill you by uttering a single word. Well, not that
Probably
they would.
True.
They seem peaceful, but I wouldn't want to provoke them.
What types of deliveries do you make to High Hrothgar?
Mostly food supplies like dried fish and salted meats. You know, things that keep fresh for a long time. The Greybeards tend not to get out much, if you catch my meaning.
And in return?
Well, it's kind of an understanding between us. I mean, it just wouldn't feel right to charge them for a bit of preserved food. Trouble is, my legs aren't what they used to be, and climbing the 7,000 steps takes its toll.
Should I be nice or should I be an ass and just leave him to his own devices? Let's be nice. We'll be nice this one. I could do it for you.
Really? Well, that would be kind of you.
I know.
Take this bag of supplies.
I'm a saint.
At the top of the steps, you'll see the offering chest. Just leave the bag inside, and you're done.
Sure thing. Anything I should watch out for during the climb?
Well, there's the occasional wolf pack or stray, but that's all I've ever had to deal with. Shouldn't be a problem for the likes of you. Other than that, watch your footing. In these wintry conditions, the stairs can be treacherous.
Well noted, my friend.
Be careful up there.
You got it. We're off to see the Greybeards. The wonderful Greybeards of Hrothgar. Back up the steps we go. Where they stop? Well, we do know it's at High Hrothgar, where the Greybeards are. You thought I was gonna say no one knows. Nope. Autumn knows. Oh my god, we're almost there. They weren't playing around when they said 7,000 steps, man. Fuck. Not a troll. Come on, man. Let's see. Oops. No! Come- Get him a couple of times with some arrows. Oh god, I didn't realize they had another eye on the top of their goddamn head. That's fucking creepy. Die! Oh thank god. Hey, you guys got to kind of see my character. Look at his feet. His feet are huge. I'll take those back, but I don't need any troll fat. Ooh, that rhymed. I'll take those back, but I don't need any troll fat. I can't rap. Oh, for God's sakes. I forgot how long this took. Oh my God. Oh, we made it. Yes! God, I feel like that took 10 years. How old am I now? Oh, 48? Okay. Good lord. Okay. No, I didn't store. There you go, there's your shit. Let's go talk to this dude.
So, a dragonborn appears at this moment.
Yes, tis me.
Turning
hello. Dude, I'm running into the wall. Dude, go the other way. I'm answering your summons.
We will see if you truly have the gift. Show us, Dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice.
That sounds real dirty. That's not what I wanted.
Shout at us. Let us taste of your voice.
I'm trying to, but never mind.
Poof!
There we go.
Dragonborn, it is you. Welcome to High Hrothgar.
Thank you.
I am Master Arngeir. I speak for the Greybeards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn, why have you come here?
You summoned me, that's why. Who are you? What is this place? I want to find out what it means to be a Dragonborn. I'm answering your summons, Master. Master Arngeir. I want to find out what it means to be Dragonborn.
We are here to guide you in that pursuit. Just as the Greybeards have sought to guide those of the dragon blood that came before you.
Very cool. You mean I'm not the only Dragonborn?
You are not the first.
Of course not.
There have been many of the dragon blood since Akatosh first bestowed that gift upon mortal kind. Whether you are the only Dragonborn of this age, that is not ours to know. You are the only one that has been revealed thus far. That is all I can say.
I'm ready to learn.
You have shown that you are Dragonborn. You have the inborn gift.
That I
but
do, my friend.
Do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path laid out for you?
Probably not.
That remains to be seen. Without training, you have already taken the first steps towards injecting your voice into a thune.
Come on, man. Don't sneak up on a man like that.
You are willing and able to learn.
Woman, technically, but I'm a man in the game.
Your dragons. Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power.
Uh-huh.
All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Ro, the second word in unrelenting force. Ro means balance. Dragon tongue. Combine it with Fus, force, to focus your thumb more sharply.
Ro.
To use it in a shout. Well, that is how the rest of us learn shouts. As Dragonborn, you can absorb a slain dragon's life force and knowledge directly. As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of Ro.
You're the dude that creeped up on me earlier. I don't want to know what you know?
You can master your new form. Use your unrelenting force shout to strike the targets as they appear.
You got it, dude.
Yeek! Go! Ah!
Boost! Go!
My bad. I knocked over the pot over there, too. Sorry, guys. Here, let me
fix
that.
Again.
There you go.
Boost! Go!
Good. God almighty. All them pots went everywhere.
You learn quickly. Once more.
One more time.
Go!
Boost! Go!
Sorry. Sorry, my bad.
Impressive. Your thumb is precise. You show great promise, Dragonborn.
I thank you, sir.
We will perform your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Bori.
You got it. Oh my god, why does he walk so slow? Do all of you guys just walk super fucking slow? I'm in a hurry! Oh, okay.
We will now see how you learn a completely new shout. Master Bori will teach you Wuld, which means whirlwind.
Projected
into a thumb.
Thank you, Master Bori. Ow. I don't know if that picked up on the mic, but my wrist just cracked like a motherfucker.
A new shout. Master Wolfgar will demonstrate whirlwind sprint. Then it will be your turn. Master
Go ahead with your bad self.
Now, it's your turn.
Okay.
Stand. Next to me, Master Bori will open the gate. Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes.
You got it. And... go!
Boom!
Yay!
Your quick mastery of a new Thum is... astonishing.
Thank you.
I'd heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, to see it for myself.
Neat, ain't it? Oh, do I want to be a cocky little bitch? Or do I want to just kind of... I don't know how it happens. It just does. Or do I simply just say thank you and what's next? Let's just say thank you.
You are now ready for your last trial. Retrieve the horn of Jürgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ostengrav. Remain true to the way of the voice.
Do I have to?
We'll return.
All right. Couple more questions for this guy first. Why are the dragons returning? Does it have something to do with me?
No doubt. The appearance of a dragonborn at this time is not an accident. Your destiny is surely bound up with the return of the dragons. You should focus on honing your voice, and soon your path will be made clear.
Thank you, Master. I will continue my training.
Good. Then you will be ready for whatever lies ahead.
Is that all? Who was Jürgen Windcaller?
He was a great war leader of the ancient Nords, a master of the voice, or tongue. After the disaster at Red Mountain, where the Nord army was annihilated, he spent many years pondering the meaning of that terrible defeat. He finally came to realize that the gods had punished the Nords for their arrogant and blasphemous misuse of the voice. He was the first to understand that the voice should be used solely for the glory and worship of the gods, not the glory of men. Jürgen Windcaller's mastery of the voice eventually overcame all opposition, and the way of the voice was born.
Very cool. What is the way of the voice?
The voice was a gift of the goddess Kinnereth at the dawn of time. She gave mortals the ability to speak as dragons do. Although this gift has often been misused, the only true use of the voice is for the worship and glory of the gods. True mastery of the voice can only be achieved when your inner spirit is in harmony with your outward actions. In the contemplation of the sky,
I like that. That's pretty cool.
Kinnereth's domain and the practice of the voice, we strive to achieve this balance.
But I don't follow your philosophy. Why help me learn the voice? Or, I will try to follow the way of voice. Let's do this one.
The Dragonborn is an exception to all the rules. The dragon blood itself is a gift of the gods. If we accept one gift, how can we deny the other? As Dragonborn, you have received the ability to shout directly from Akatosh. We therefore seek to guide you on the proper use of your gift, which transcends the restrictions which bind other mortals.
Very cool.
Sky, guard you.
Thank you, sir. Alright, well, I am gonna leave this episode of Skyrim here. Good God! This has taken forever, and I've literally only done, what, one full part of this whole main quest? Of this small segment? This game is so incredibly long. I've been recording for an hour now, and I've only done this. That's just absolutely insane. I always forget how long this game is. Just, I don't play it over and over and over. I mean, I've played it through twice already. This will be my third time. But I love this game. I mean, it's fantastic. The graphics are great, especially when they remastered it. And I just love the storyline, and I really, really like this kind of medieval feel. That's why I really like Fallout 2, because the game style is the same, the gameplay is almost the exact same, but it's a little more futuristic, and I really like this kind of medieval feel to said video games. And I even tried to play, oh god, what is the name of that game? Dragon Age Inquisition. That's the one. I even tried to play that. I wasn't that big of a fan of it. The style was pretty neat, and I liked the, you know, you can still use magic and stuff like that, obviously. I really stick with magic and my bow. That's kind of, like, my thing. But, I don't know, there was something about that game. I think it was because I made my character try, like, kind of look more like an elf, and he ended up looking like an apple with toothpicks, like, sticking out of the bottom. For some reason, his top half was really large, and then his legs were just itty-bitty. But anyways, I'm gonna end up rambling, and this video is just not gonna go anywhere. But anyway, thank you guys for watching. If you liked this video, please leave me a like and leave me a comment saying hello and tell me what you guys want to see next. Remember to subscribe so that you get all of my notifications for whenever I post new videos. I think I'm gonna start posting once every day. I'm maybe gonna start doing two a day, because now that I've got a little bit more of a sporadic schedule, I think I can record a couple videos in one day. That way I can schedule them to come out at least once a day. That's what I'm gonna try and do. So if you guys want to keep up, just hit the little subscribe button on my YouTube channel and hit that little bell so you get notifications whenever I post new videos. So just, you know, keep in touch. I like hearing from you guys, and I love responding to your comments. So far, this has been a blast. I really like interacting with everybody. And, but yeah, anyways, thank you guys, and I will see you guys in the next video.